Hello, hello. Welcome in, everyone. How you doing? Happy Monday, I guess. I'm not exactly awake, but that's okay. But yeah, how are y'all doing? We're gonna have a nice chill co-working stream today. Doing more prepping for getting sales and commissions of some of my pixel art icons, emotes, those sort of things up. So I hit my keyboard. So that's what I'm working on today. I'm basically, my goal for today is to go through like all the emotes I have made so far and start sorting them into collections and then making a nice little, what do we call it? Like a portfolio page, basically, so you can see all of them. Hey, welcome in, Raiders. How you doing? I hope your stream was good. I was semi-lurking for part of it, but also was doing other stuff. But hey, welcome in. I am working on prepping art sales stuff today. So basically, I'm going through the emotes I have so far. I'm going to make a nice little spreadsheet, I guess, of all of them. Is quiet but productive. That's a good stream. I really enjoy those streams sometimes. I had one of those last week when I had like no viewers, but I got a lot of work done. So it actually wasn't that bad. But yeah, so today I'm organizing my emotes. Hopefully gonna make a like catalog page basically that looks nice. And then also make a list of what emotes I need to make on Wednesday. So that's my plan for today. And hopefully I'll get a lot done. But yeah, okay. Let's get some music on. That's what I need to do. Then, wow, my brain is being slow this morning. Okay, I know what I'm doing. There we go. Let's get some music on. Yeah. Alright, thanks for the raid as always, and I hope you have a great day. And yeah, I'm hoping I can get a lot done today, because I really want to get my like emote store open. I think that would be nice. But I'm hoping I can get all the like emotes collected and organized by the end of this week. And then next week I can work on like writing up TOS and like the posts and stuff. So maybe in like 2 weeks, maybe I'll have my store up? We'll see. But yeah, okay. I think I'll go ahead and get started now. As always, feel free to chat, feel free to lurk, whatever you want to do, and I hope we just all have a nice chill and or productive time in the guild today. So yeah, let's get started. First thing I need to decide is if I'm gonna put all the emotes in one set, because I have, I think I just counted and I forgot, I think I have like 28 emotes at the moment, so I need to decide if I'm gonna do one big collection. I could probably do one big collection. We'll see. I'll just start putting the emotes in and see how many I can fit on that looks good. Yeah, we'll start with that. First thing I want to see is, can you you can drag and drop files into Canva. That helps a lot. Okay. That's way too big. Yeah, I think... Yeah, I guess I'll start by just uploading all my emotes, and then I'll go from there, figure out what I want to do. That sounds like a good idea. It's slightly annoying that it loads them so big, but that's okay. Obviously, I'll make all these the same size once I get them all in, but I'm just gonna arbitrarily size them at the moment. I just realized that most of these don't have a white outline. Which is normally what I do. I normally do both a black and white outline so that they will show up well on both light and dark surfaces. I'm just realizing a lot of these don't have that. But that's okay for this set. I'm not going to worry about it, but that is something I need to remember to keep in mind future. Like, I think all the ones... Oh, I don't... It's really strange. I thought I did it with more, but apparently I didn't. I did it with a few, but... It's not that big of a deal. Like, generally, you probably wouldn't notice, but I do try to... both the dark and white. Dark and light border. Oh well. I'm gonna say like this one, but you can't tell because this one does have a white border. So that, for example. I change the background? Yeah, I can. Oh dear. Yeah, see, that's why... This is a good example of why it's smart to put a white background around your icons, because if they're used on a black background, all these ones that had black things become invisible, whereas this one, you can still see, you know, like the lid and stuff. But luckily, it should be fine, because I don't think... Yeah, see, as long as it's not, like, pure black, you can still... It still stands out well enough. And I don't think there are many contexts where they'd be used on a pure black background. Yeah, I did kind of mess that up, but I am not gonna... I'm not going to bother changing that for this one, this set. but I will make myself a note. Remind me, but the white borders. Although it's really bugging me. Okay, now I need to decide if it's worth the effort to go back in and add white borders to all these. Like, I want to, because it's bugging me. I can be a bit of a perfectionist. But I don't know if it's worth the time. Because it is slightly time consuming when you have to re-download. Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna this time. I guess what I could do. I could just add the white borders when people order a custom color. Because I'll have to edit and re-download or re-export them anyways. Yeah, that's fine. I'll do that. Okay. I need to make a note for myself. Remember to do that. Whoops, I just now realized that my model wasn't moving. There we go, I can move again. One problem with getting a web camera with a privacy screen, whatever you want to call it, is sometimes I forget to open it. I'm a genius like that. There we go, now we can move. I can rock out to this nice music. Hello, Deshores. How you doing? I just realized that I don't think I have all my emotes in this folder. Where are they? Where'd I put them? Oh, I just copied them over to the right folder. I did export them. Just then didn't put them in the right folder. One moment while I do that. There we go. Don't bother, did I? Whoops. That's not what I meant to do. Just, I didn't mean to upload all of them. One of them. There we go. Okay. This is really bugging me how I remembered to put white borders on a few of these, but not all of them. Yeah, I have just a few. There's a lot of them. And this isn't even all of them. And there's a few that I need to make. Possibly not for this set. I very least need, like, I want to make a heart emoji for this set at very least. I feel like that's needed. The others I might wait. And I can show off one which is not going to go here. But I really like it, so I'm gonna show it off, but it's not for sale. I just really like it. Look at it. Oh, well, you can't. Yeah, hard to see. I'm very proud of this emote that I made during Books Brews and Brews stream yesterday with her new little eyeball buddy. I like it a lot. But this one's not for sale. I just really like it. I think it's kind of cute. But we'll remove that one. That one is not a for sale emote. But yeah, let me see what's on my. Okay, yeah, I think for this set, I am gonna add a heart. But then I think that'll be good because there are a lot of emotes in this set. And I think next I might do a Halloween themed set. Because that just seems like fun. Bookstream also got me kind of in a Halloween mood, apparently. So I might do a Halloween set next. But for this, just kind of generic miscellaneous emotes, I think I will just do these and then a heart, which I will make on Wednesday. Actually, I think okay, I think I will okay, I was gonna put my heart emote in here just as a placeholder, and I'm now forgetting where I saved it. Oh, I know where it is. I have too many folders on my computer. Here? No, it's not. Here. There it is. Okay. Yeah, so this heart is not going to be in this set. It's just going to be a placeholder for the heart I will make. I'm keeping the the thorny heart for myself, but I will make a normal heart, which I'll put in, so that'll just be a little placeholder. Okay. Now to make this little, like, catalog page thing look nice. How do I want to do this? It would be nice if the way, like, put a grid on this, but I don't know if there is. Oh, show rulers and guides. Oh, no, that's not what I want. Okay, I guess you... Okay, so I guess you can make your own grid, which is actually kind of cool. A little more work for me, but I guess it works. Okay. Okay. Time to do math, I guess. If I do want to make an actual, like, even grid, which probably makes sense. Or I could just freehand it and see what happens. I don't know which is the better option. So I spend the time now to, like, do some quick math and figure out a layout, or do I just freehand it, which could be faster, unless it ends up looking horrible and then I have to calculate a grid anyways. I don't know what I'm feeling this morning. Okay, maybe I think I'll take the math route. Let's first see how many emotes I have here. There's a lot, and I don't remember how many. Seven. I have an odd number of them. There are 37 icons, and this square is 1080 by 1080. And okay, grab a calculator and see how we can be clever. Okay, I don't know if my brain is awake enough for this kind of math. Let's see. Uh, Okay, if I took one out, that'd be 36 icons. I could then do a 6x6 grid. And then do... Yeah, 6x6 grid, which would be 180 pixels per grid box. Okay, let's see what that looks like. Oh my goodness, this is not gonna be very exact after all. Damn. Dang, it's making me do math. Why is it making me add? I don't like adding. 360. Yes, I know that's basic addition right there, but I don't care. Wait, why? Can't I make? I wonder if it's because it's, I think it's snapping to things on the thing already. That's annoying. Let me try this. There we go, that's better. Okay, so I do need to make the grid before putting the things on. But it looks like the grid stays in place, so that's fine. So I can make the grid here. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, and then it snaps up here. Okay. It's not like 720. It keeps jumping between 19 and 21. Why? It doesn't look like 720. 720 does exist to it, apparently. Fine, it'll be 719. Close enough. It's a pixel off, but that's fine. Now we just need to do the same. One, where? Reading numbers sideways is. It is. Is there a way where you can just like type in the numbers? Because, okay, that's close enough. I do kind of like this freeform grid. It is kind of useful. I wish there was also just like a freeform grid, but it doesn't look like there is. There we go. If 720 exists this way. Oh, I saw it for a moment. Where'd it go? There we go. It knows 720 in that direction, and then 900. Okay, good enough. There we go. And I have a 6x6 grid. Okay, so now I think I'll just I think I will just fit each icon to the grid like that. That'll be the easiest way to keep the like icon sizes all standard. Which does mean there's not really room for any like title or like identifying number for each icon, but I think that'll be okay. I'll make like a text list that's in order, and that should be fine. There shouldn't be any confusion about what that means. In this case, because like they're almost, the items are all different, so I can just say what they are, and that shouldn't be a problem. And my original idea was to have like the name of the icon or like a number. But I think it'll be fine. Oh no, don't do that. So many things overlapping here. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'll size them all first, and then I'll reorganize them. I don't necessarily want them in this order, but first things first, just get them all the right size. Oh, the other thing I might do is I might make a preview image of what these look like. I'll probably do it in basically I'll load them into either Discord or Build It, so I could just take like a screenshot of all of them so you can see what sort of what they look like when they're in use in that setting. That might be good, so I might do that. I have a like private test Discord server, so I could load them all up in there and then like make a example message just with all of them. You can get a feel of what they look like as an emote. Yeah, I might do that. I feel like that would probably be useful. Get a better feel of what these look like in action than just in, rather than just in kind of a zoomed in catalog page like I have here. Yeah, they are very small, which is why I'm thinking, yeah, it might be good to add an example of what they look like in a chat setting. Which, so yeah, it wouldn't be exactly the same as what it would look like on Twitch, because I'd be doing it in either Guild or Discord. But it would give you a better idea of what it looks like. I also just realized that I didn't have to actually make the grid, because I could just zoom the things. It shows that the values when you resize the things, but that's fine. So now, be more accurate to rescale these to the size rather than based off of the grid. Well, that's fine for now. I want them to be approximately all the same size, but it's hard to get them exactly the same size. At least until I figure out if there's a... Oh dang it. A way to manually put in the size, like with a keyboard. Doing with a mouse is kind of challenging. Fine. Oh right, I also need to pick one. Take out. I might take out one of these, because these two are essentially the same. I'm gonna remove that one. There we go. Now I have 26. Admit, I'm rather proud of this teacup. I think it turned out pretty well. And I finally added it as the break time redeem icon. That's what I made it for, and then I forgot to actually change the icon for like ages, and now I finally did. I also added a few of these emotes to the Gilded server. There's a couple more emotes on there. Which also reminds me, I am gonna do a pride flag emote set. Seeing I have those. That one I might just do a might just be a you buy all of them. This one you'll get to pick which ones you want and you'll be able to change the colors. But I think the pride flag might just be like a you instant buy the whole set. But we'll see. Love the little grilled cheese sandwich. Which is so cute. Okay, there we go. They're all approximately the same size now. Let me see. I don't know if I like that though. Because there's not much spacing between each icon. So, I think I'm gonna make them smaller. And possibly put a put actual grid lines, maybe. Do like some black grid lines dividing them. Well, let's start by making these all slightly smaller. So we're currently 180. Let's try. Actually, I'm gonna try. That's kind of an 180. Let's try 60. 50. Oh my goodness, so many lines. I really need to see if there's a way it'd be very useful if there was just like a transform button. You could click on a thing . Hello VTuber Royal Mini Matt, how you doing? Long time no see. I hope you are having a good day, and have a happy lurk! Yeah, it'd be really nice if there was a way... Oh, edit image? No. I want a way where you click on an image and then you could just type in... Like, type in what size you want. It doesn't really look like there's a way to do that. If there is, I don't know it. I'm still relatively new at using this program. Like, it's really nice, but yeah, there's a few things I wish it had. But it is a free like graphics design site, so I can't really complain because I'm not paying money for it, but it would make my life easier if I could just type in the size I want this. And I suppose I could Yeah, a lot of things do, but I am not seeing it anywhere. And I've checked basically everything. Oh, wait. Oh, that's... I bet this is what it is. No. No, I don't know. Now that resize looks like it's for the like whole file, not the individual image. So there is a chance that if you had the paid version, then maybe. But now this... That resize looks like it's for the whole canvas, not an individual item. You know what? I'm gonna check Google. Maybe I am just missing something. Let's see. Okay, yeah, looks like the only resize method is dragging, which is kind of annoying. In general, that's fine. If you're wanting really specific sizes like I want here, that's really inconvenient and a pain. So probably what I would need to do, I don't think I'll do it here, but for the future what I would need to do then is basically set the size of the image before I load it in. I think that would work. Let's try that. Oh wait, no, because no, that won't work. Because okay, now I'm just getting myself confused. No, that won't work. Because when I uploaded, it's like I uploaded all these images from, basically what I'm saying is it changed the file size, I think. Yeah, because okay, let me try this. Yeah, no, it doesn't keep the It doesn't keep the image size upload, because this is the 28 by 28 pixel version. Okay. But uploads. What is it? How does this software work? So let's see, if I put it in here, size is this little file. Okay, the point is, it does not preserve the size of the image when you import it. So maybe this was not the best bit of software for doing this. All this resizing is a pain. Time to have a think about this. I'm wondering if it might be I'm gonna open up another. Okay. Apparently today is experimentation day. I'm gonna open up another program, see if that might work better. Except I've used this program even less, so let's see if I can even figure out how to get a just get like a canvas open. Okay. And I will switch it over If I do keep using this, I'll switch over the screen so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just doing a quick test first to see if this might be easier. Because again, I've used this even less, so I don't even know how to do anything. Where's the import button? Where's the export button? Open as layers. That's right. It's called something different in this room. Okay. Just grab one. Okay. No, that's not what I wanted. Here. Oh, there it is. There. Okay. Okay, I think this software is gonna be better. Let's try it. I will. I guess I'll make a new source so you can see what I'm doing. Yeah. Just bear with me a moment, and I'll get this figured out. Go. Okay. I think that's fine. Do that, and then let me pull this over here so I can see what I'm doing. Okay. Oh, that's really small, isn't it? Okay. I'm gonna try using, what's this thing called? GIMP. So this does allow you to like resize things and stuff. I just forgot how I do that. No. Scale image. Yeah. No, not scale image. I figured it out and then I. Oh, no. I do this? Layer. There we go. Yeah. So this one, you can type in the numbers and it maintains your image size when you import it. That should make my life way easier. We're gonna try using this instead. I mean, Canva's great for a lot of things, but that was gonna drive me insane trying to manually resize everything. And I do not like the way this is laid out, but that's fine. if I use this more, I'll have to customize the layout of this workspace because I am not liking it. But for now, fine. Make that bigger. There we go. Then, well, okay. That's just gonna have to do for now. It doesn't exactly look pretty on stream, but it's fine for now. If I keep using this, I'll make it look nicer. But for now, I just wanna try to get this finished. So. What size? Okay, so I decided to try 150. We'll scale each layer to 50 by 150. I will want. Okay. Let's first see if I can just have a grid. Show grid. Now, how do I change the size of the grid? Show grid, how do you? Customize the grid. Things maybe? Let me just hide this for a moment, just in case it shows something I don't want it to show. There we go. Default. I don't want necessarily to change the default grid, but that's fine. Okay, I don't think that even did what I wanted. Didn't change the grid. Did I not save it? Ah, way to go. Edit. References. Alt grid. Is not working. Oh, I don't know what that did. Undo. Okay. Hide that grid because I don't like it and I don't know how to change it. Okay, I can. Get rid of those. Let me do. Okay. Where are the grid settings? Grid show guide. Yeah, that grid's too small. I need a bigger grid. Oh, configure grid. It's over there. I found it. Okay. I don't know why. Oops. It's kind of annoying that the... Okay. So the show grid is in view, which makes sense. And then the configure grid is an image. Okay. Well, now I know where they are at least, so that's good. Now I think I want... have a line tool? Where's the line tool? Surely I must have a line tool. Or not. English. Just want to make a grid. I'm gonna do a grid for now. I'm just going to use this the grid to line things up. Okay. Let me hide this for a sec. And then yeah. And then then we import this one, and then we do scale layer 150. Scale. There we go. That's so much easier. I actually might want this. I want this grid slightly smaller. I can center these better. Let's see. Image. Get away. Pick your grid. It would be nice if you could have like two grids. Okay, that's fine for now. I don't want to do this. Okay, let's see what these guides are. Guide, horizontal. Let's say, okay. What's in there? Yeah, so I can use the guides to up. Okay. That'll work. Okay. Right. Okay. We could do new guide. Vertical position will be. I want to center these in the column. The position would be one 180 divided by 2. Yeah, because each box is 180. So B, that's not the right number. So 90. Okay. There we go. And now, that one. And now, oh, there we go. Now I'll be centered in each box. Okay, we're making progress. This is working a lot better. Yay, being able to be accurate. Okay. So, I'm gonna take a really quick break to refill my water, and I'll come back and properly start doing this now that I have a software. That was a weird sentence. Now that I'm using a software where I can actually control the size of things accurately. So yeah, we're gonna take a quick break. Feel free to get up, stretch your legs, get some food, get some water, do whatever you need to do, and we'll be back in a few minutes. Oh, bother. I used a different schedule thing, and it's wrong. How do I do this? I'll hide that for now. If you want the schedule, you have to follow me on socials, because I broke it. Okay, anyways, take your break now. Be right back. Okay, I'm back. So now, go ahead and get the rest of the... What are they called? Guidelines? Guidelines? Where was it? Guides. New guide. But this one... 90 plus 180. 270. Not 270. Okay, here we go. Yeah! Okay. Then 450. Guide. 50. Might be a more efficient way to do this. I don't know, but this is fine. 450. 6. 30. 630. And then... finally, 90. Where am I going? You got it. 990. Okay. Okay, so I think what I will do, dang it, is I will hit the wrong button. There we go. Yeah, so now, now they will snap to the grid. The top of the, or it'll snap to the grid and the grid line. So they'll be centered and then up to the top. I think it'll work well. Okay, so let's... Yeah, so now let's just get the rest in. I'm just gonna... Yeah, I think I'm gonna temporarily hide my screen for a minute and just import all of them instead of hiding and unhiding my screen for every icon. So I'm just gonna upload them all at once and then resize them. Okay. Thank you. Okay. I have all of the icons imported now. Now we need to make it so that they are not a giant stack on top of each other. Also, fail layer. 150. Now we should be able to just yay. Okay, this is so much better than what I was doing before. Fail layer. Still slightly tedious. Because I have to rescale everything. Probably what I'll try to do next time is I'll make it so that I export the files in the size I want instead of changing them here. But for this time around, this is fine. I mean, I suppose I could. I guess I could keep them at 112x112. And then I would have space. I could put like a title or like, you know, the name of the icon underneath them. I'm actually gonna try that first. Let's just line these guys all up. I probably will reorder some of these, but for now, I'm just gonna put them over. There's one missing because I don't have the heart. So now I need to decide. I hit the wrong button. I want to hide those for now. Okay. Maybe I will just keep them at 112. Let me switch these back. Okay, I think that actually looks fine. And that'll save me a lot of time. Yeah, okay. So now each image is 112 by 112 square, which is the size of one of the files you get. Okay. Yeah, I think I'll do this. And then... Let me see what it looks like. I don't know if I do I want to put a grid in? Kind of thinking not. A little much. So now the next question is, do I want to label each icon or not bother and just have in the like text description? It's like all these icons are different enough that I don't think, like, the only two that might get people confused are the two different floppy disks. All the other ones are different. That should be easy to tell just from like a descriptor what they are. Yeah, so maybe I'll just do, basically just do this. The one thing I don't like though is, okay, I'm gonna see what it looks like if I center, like completely center instead of snapping to the top of the grid. Because now there's like no board at the top and some board at the bottom, and that's kind of bugging me. So what we need to do now is, I'll do this. Add new horizontal guides. I guess we'll that one. Should be able to. Yeah, there we go. So we'll center them. Better. Okay. hit the wrong button. Undo. Why don't... Stop. Is there a way to... Wait, the lock layers? Is that what this was? Is that lock? No? Oh. What? Okay. That seemed to have worked. Okay, there we go. They're all centered now. Now let's hide. Hit that. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. Well, I am gonna rearrange a couple of these so that related items are next to each other. But I think this will work. And then. Either as another image or just like the text and the like shop page thing. I'll have a... One sec, I'm gonna sneeze. I'll have a like list that goes through all of these and like has the name of the item and then what colors can or can't be customized. It's like some of them, like the sandwich, for example, you can only change the color of the cheese because, well, it may be the crust, but the, like inside the bread, because it has like a gradient thing going on, it would just be a pain. And then the different pens. I guess I would give the option to change the nib. Well, the pen's sort of special in that there are three default versions, but you can't change all the colors. And then this one you can't change, so. Yeah, so that's my plan. I'll have this, and there'll be a heart down here, and then I'll have it's like a text list. I list all the items, like all the item names, and what can and can't be changed on them. And yeah, I think that'll work. Okay, so what I need to do now is organize a few of these. I want like the pens, for example, all together. I might also group together ones that the colors can't change, or that there are limited color changes available. I guess I might as well put the two signs next to each other also. How do I want to group these? I mean, it doesn't really matter, but... Oh, I need to decide if... I think I can allow the magnifying glass to be fully changed. I was going to say you can't change glass color. I'll have to think about that. Whether I'll allow the glass color to be changed. Because the tricky part about that is you then have to... It takes a bit extra work because you have to like balance the colors properly to make it look decent. I'm tempted not to allow that change. But I might. We'll see. Okay. I think I'll move all the pens down here. Actually, I think I want to I'll do the ones that can't be changed. I'll put those on the end. That'd be these, well, can't be changed or have limited changes possible. That one can't be changed at all because it's all gradient. These two have limited changes. This gradient part can't be changed because it would just be a pain. And then I think. All the others, everything can be changed relatively easily. Well, okay, I might put the magnifying glass down. I might put restrictions on how much you can change that. I haven't decided yet. Put that down there. Signs next to each other. I guess we could put the two floppy disks next to each other also. It probably makes sense to group like things together, so I put all the cups together. I don't know if it really matters, but apparently that's what I'm doing. You can tell I like organizing things. This is very enjoyable. I'm having fun doing this. Is it necessary to organize things like this? Probably not. But it's fun, so I'm doing it anyways. Okay, I think I like this layout. I have everything grouped kind of by a theme, sort of. And then I have the like special color cases down at the bottom. The things that can't be changed, things that have some things that can't be changed, and this one that just has a few different examples of the same thing. And then one that I might omit, and then some random things, so the heart will go in here. Yeah, okay, let's hide the grid lines. Okay, yeah, I like that. I think that looks pretty good. So now, let's save this. Why do I want to save this? Leave it there for now. Well, this emote. Call this emote group one. Make a new folder for these. Call these catalogs. Catalog. I hate that word. That's not how you spell it. What? If you'd been quiet, then you wouldn't know that I can't spell. You can't see that I can't spell, but I said it, so now you know. Oh, why? I was making it way more difficult to spell than it is. Yes. Okay. Put it in that folder. Save. Also, while I'm thinking about it, anyone who cares, I have my the Moriarty the Patriot / Sherlock Holmes fanfic I have been working on stream for a few weeks is now finished and up on AO3. You can find the link in the link tree, which is in chat at the moment, or you can use hashtag socials to find it. But yes, it's up there now. And yeah, typing it up in HTML as I went made my life posting so much easier, which is why I posted all 13 chapters at once. I thought I was gonna do like a few each day like I did before, because my old method required a lot of like time and effort to format it on AO3. But now I literally copy paste and it's all formatted. I can get things up a lot faster, which is exciting. So they're all up there now. Okay. So we now have this catalog page finished as much as possible until I get the heart emoji made, which I'll do tomorrow. So now I will do basically the same sort of thing, but with the pride flag emotes. So let me see how many of those I have. Don't remember. Have I not? Oh, I'm in the wrong folder. That's why I can't find what I'm looking for. Pride flags. Okay, let's see how many I have. Okay, looks like I have 20. So, how do I want to do this? I kind of want to keep the same canvas size for all of them, just for consistency. But if I do that, I kind of want to keep everything the same size, but if I do that, that means I'll have a lot of extra white space. I have a lot fewer flags than what I have in this current group that's on screen. And there are technically some flags I haven't done, I think, but there aren't that many. Well, I'll start by... let's see, if I have 20, that would be... that would be... yeah, so it's like this many. It'll be like half full. Which, I mean, that's fine, actually. Then I could put like a legend of what each flag is in the white space. Okay, yeah, so let's do that. Let's figure out the best way to do that. Guessing. One sec. Doesn't copy over the guides. Is there a way to like transfer the guides from one file to the other, because that would be helpful. Buttons for new guides. Let me look in the properties, see if there is like a default guides option, because that'd be helpful. I'm kind of guessing there's not. Oh, well, I could just do a grid that is the same as these guides, and then I could snap to the grid instead of the guides. That should work. Yeah, so it's a 180 grid offset by 90? Let's see if that works. Configure grid. 180 offset 90. Yeah. Yay! There we go! And now I can snap to... make sure it does snap to grid. And yeah, so that should work, I think. That should work the same way the guides worked on the other file. But now I don't need to put in each line separately. So I'm going to hide my screen for a moment again, and I'll just upload all the emotes, and then we'll work on organizing them and such. I do need a test later, because there's a chance that the open file window won't be picked up in my OBS, but just in case, I'm gonna hide it for now, and then I'll test later, see if I can get it so I don't have to completely hide my screen every time I need to open a file. But it's fine. I mean, I like my hide screen thing. Okay, we have them all. And I think I'll just organize them in the way they got imported, which they'll be in reverse alphabetical order. That seems simple enough. Yeah, there we go. Okay. I know how to make the grid more efficiently now, so that's good. So it's useful to be able to make each guideline separately, but when you're doing a grid, that's a bit of a pain. Here we go! Lots of cute little flags. And yeah, there are a few more I could add, but I don't know if it would really be. Well, I might add a few more, or I might just use this blank space to add basically a legend saying what each one is. It won't look quite as awkward. There'll be stuff in this big blank space. Just, yeah, okay, let's hide the grid, see what it looks like. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, let's hide the screen so I can save this. Okay, and we'll call this... Pride Flags 1. I don't know if there will ever be a Pride Flags 2, but in case there is. Okay, we got those done. Okay, so what else do I need to do? I guess. I guess that's actually the main... that was the main thing I had to do today, so I reached my goal, apparently. That's good. 2 hours. Took 2 hours to figure out how to do it all. Of course, that means I'll be much faster next time, so that's cool. So, what I'm gonna do now is... Today's August. I'm trying to decide if it makes sense to start. Okay. Let's see what we've got. Okay, so I have my general, like, miscellaneous emote / icon set. That looks all good to go. I have Pride Flag set. Yeah, that's all good to go. So I have those two, and then... Okay. I'm trying to decide how I want to do this. I'm also thinking of doing a set where basically you can get either the folder or the little sign with another icon like on top of it. Then I'll probably... do that as like Microsoft icons. You can have custom computer folder icons, which honestly, I don't know if I think people would be interested in, but I think it's really cool. That's what I did for, well, quite a few of my folders, but especially my like pictures folder, because I had so many subfolders. Now almost each one has a custom icon, so you can easily just like look at the icon and know what the folder is without having to like read the folder name, which I think is really useful. So I'm gonna put up a thing where you can basically customize those, so you get custom icon folders, which, yeah, but I might also either do, I might do two versions of that set, or like two like store pages for that set. One where you get Microsoft icons. Maybe I could look to see if it works. I should look to see if it works for like Mac and Linux, and if not, what you can do for those systems. Okay, I should put that on my to-do list. I need to check that. Linux. There we go. We'll check that. And then if like Mac and Linux work in a similar way to Windows, I could have, well, if it works in a similar way and it's a different file type, I could have an option to either get the Windows or Mac or Linux versions. And I'll have both the sign and the folder. And I think I'll have a separate store maybe that's the same thing. Where you pick either the sign or the folder and what icon to put on that item. But instead of being computer folder file types, it'll be email file types. Maybe? I think for that it would... If I did do that, I'd probably do only default colors or the icons, maybe. I would have to think about that, whether I would do custom icons or custom colors. Maybe I'll wait on that one. Just do the folder icons. Oh, okay. So that means I also need to decide if for the folders, you'd definitely be able to change the background color. And the next question is whether change the icon color, or if it would just use the default icon colors. Think about it. Oh, that's the other one I don't have. I did also have a computer monitor emote that I was thinking of including. Nah, I'll save that for the next batch. I think this is a good selection. Yeah, so I need to decide the icon. Hmm. Yeah, okay, I'll need to think about that more. Whether for the computer icon set, change the color of the icons. Okay, so, but what I need to do for that one, I need to make a, it's another thing like this, only with an example of the layered icon, so you can kind of see what it would look like. I guess we'll do that now. Let's go ahead and do that. Okay. Oh, grid. I'm gonna have to reformat the grid again. That's fine. Take your grid. But keeps your grid spacing. Oh, maybe because I put that. That might be the default grid spacing. That makes sense. Okay. There's that. So now. Up, I need to hide the screen again. Then you import a few different things. So I need to import the folder, sign, and one other emote of some sort. There's the blank sign. What is it? What do I call it? I called it sign. Okay. And then, let's see, what icon should we use? Maybe let's do the beaker, maybe? Maybe I'll do two. Beaker and one other one. No. Or do I want to do the same one on both? Well, okay. I'll do the same one on both. For now. Now, at least. I hit the wrong button. Okay. So. Do it this way. I don't think snap to grid's on. Snap to grid. Thank you. There we go. And then, obviously we need to scale these down a bit. Let's try... Not 100, 880. There we go. That's still too big. I need me. Try 60. Yeah, there we go. This one. Okay, there we go. So it looks something like that. By the grid. And then I will. Basically, I'll fill in the space with instructions. Yeah, instructions on what like how to order the selections, so like which ones you need to pick. And then I'll probably do, maybe include instructions on how to use the files. Because I'm guessing most people probably haven't used custom icon files before. Okay. I think that'll work, but I need to... I could make those a little bigger, but I think that's fine. I'm kind of wondering if I should make these backgrounds a different color than white. Because like the beaker, I don't know if it's clear enough that that's clear. Let's... I'll try doing that. If I can figure out how to change colors. There we go. Color. Come on, there. Okay, yeah, I think that's better. And then I will make a note in the post that that icons without white outline out blah 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 I can talk without white outlines will be given a white outline. I suppose I could give the option of what you want to outline. Okay, I'll have to think about that also, whether I give people the choice if they want a white outline. If I just put the outline, and I'll probably put, a black and white outline on that. Okay, I think that's fine. A white background. No. I mean, the only reason this one kind of needed a different color background is for the bigger. But I'm just realizing that I should keep it white so you can see what it looks like. Okay, yeah, now maybe I will leave the background white. So I'll then have an example image of the icons in use on a dark background. So then you can see you can get a bit of a feel what they look like on both light and dark background. Okay. Yeah, so I think I'll do that. Leave that white. Leave that like that. Have order instructions and maybe usage instructions on there. Okay, I think that'll work. Let me hide the screen for a minute while I save this one. We'll call this okay. I really need to mess around with my things and see why my model's mouth sometimes just looks like it's talking even though I'm not saying anything. Okay. So, where are we at? I got the main group done. Red font group done. Theater icons. I mean, sort of done. Okay, so what all... Okay, I need to make a list. What else I need to do? Okay, so I need to get... I'll say this... sample image. And then... Greek legend. And that's not how you spell that word. And I guess in this list I'll also put POS because I need to do that. And yeah, so I think those are the main things I still need to do before I can get these up for sale. Okay. I think I'm also going to... I think I'm gonna brainstorm a Halloween set. Because if I am doing a Halloween set, I'll need to get that out relatively soon so that people can get it before Halloween. Maybe I'll do like a Halloween slash autumn set. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is what I want to do this. Okay, I'm actually going to try to remember how to do things. Okay, I'm gonna switch over. Oh, it's the button I want. I'm just gonna pull Canva back up so you can kind of see what I'm doing. So I'm just gonna brainstorm some like holiday emotes. Well, not holiday. That sounds like Christmas and stuff. Halloween. Well, I'm gonna try to and fail, apparently. Okay. Okay. And anyone in chat? Feel free to shout out any ideas you have, and I might make them. Yeah, right now I'm just basically just gonna make, yeah, just brainstorm some like Halloween or autumn themed emotes that I might make on Wednesday. So I'm gonna make a bunch more emotes on Wednesday. Do a heart and a few other things I already have planned. Oh, yeah. Okay, so Halloween emotes. We could try ghost. Pumpkin. Oh dear. Pumpkin. I could spell. Flash jack-o-lantern. Panther. Wait. My hands have a mind of their own today. What else could we do? That could be Halloween. Horn. I'm just kind of mixing Halloween and fall in this list, but that's fine. Leaves. Obviously fall colored leaves, not just any old leaf. What else? Coffin. Not how you spell that. I was gonna say apples, but I mean those are fallish, but they also aren't. What else? I could do be a haunted house. Might be a little too complex for a little emote, but we'll see. What else could we do? Oh, we could just do like a skeleton. Yeah, that's not how you spell that. Why does that not look right? As I always say, I'm a writer, not a speller. Oh, I did spell it right. It just looked weird. Okay. Well, now I did spell it right. Skeleton. There we go. Partial or full. It might not be a full one. Vampire? Maybe? Or bat. We could do bat. Vampire might. Yeah, I'll put it on the list, vampire. I don't know quite how I would do that, but we'll put it on the list. Red moon. That's sort of spooky. Werewolf. Put that on the list. Oh, a cauldron. Oh. Okay. Also kind of want to put like hay bales, which isn't exactly fallish, but it kind of is. What else? Oh, what's going on with my model there? Okay, let's Google for some inspiration. That. Oh, I don't think that's gonna work. It's just getting. That just got me all leave. Okay, let's Googling something else. Fall emotes. No, not fall guy emotes. Fine, autumn. Autumn emotes. I'll stop being lazy and spell out autumn instead of fall. That didn't actually give me much. I'm just getting pumpkins and leaves. Oh, there's a. Okay, like a witch. Gosh. Witch hat. I guess I could do. Like a turkey for Thanksgiving? Maybe? Autumn pixelized gets me. Now again, this is just like, which are pretty. Oh, a cat, a black cat. Black cat. There we go. Okay, so let's try Halloween now. Hello. Well, I I misspelled Halloween, but I'm gonna trust. Oh, a tombstone. Stone. And a mausoleum. How do you spell mausoleum? Whatever. That's not how you okay. It does have spell check. There we go. Mausoleum. I totally spelled it right the first time. Ooh, spooky candles. List is too long. Okay, what? That's not how you spell. Spiders slash webs. I think I have most of them now. Okay, so that's a decent list. A mix of some Halloween and some like autumn ideas. I'll work on some of these on Wednesday. I'll see how many I get done. And so maybe I'll be able to do a Halloween / autumn set. That could also help me, you know, get this done, being it essentially puts a deadline on me. Because you obviously need to get Halloween and fall emotes out before Halloween and fall is over. That's good. Okay. So yeah, let's see. What else do I want to work on today? We have emotes and I have also the heart emote I need to do. Yeah, that's probably what I'll do on Wednesday. So yeah, Wednesday will be these, the heart emote. Okay. Okay. Bear with me while I decide what I want to do now. Let's see. We've been streaming for 2.5 hours, which is kind of a short stream. Okay. I think what I'm gonna do, got a lot of progress done today. We got essentially 3 what I'm gonna call catalog sheets done for selling emotes, so that's great. We got a nice little brainstorm list of like seasonal icons to play around with making on Wednesday. Made a list of what else I need to work on to get my emote store up. And yeah, so I think I've been streaming for two and a half hours. I'm conflicted. I kind of want to keep streaming, but at the same time, I have a bunch of off-stream stuff I need to work on. And I want to get everything I need What is that sentence? I want to get everything I need to do today done by like 2 p.m. because the Given dub drops around 2 p.m. and I am so excited to watch it. I'm gonna binge watch like the whole thing and die of feels, and it'll be amazing. So yeah, I think I'm gonna end here so that I can go work on some off-stream stuff that I need to do. And then, yeah, watch the Given dub when it comes out because I'm too excited. But yeah, so thank you everyone for stopping by. Shortest stream today, but I got a lot done. I think it went well for me. I hope you enjoyed your time here. And I hope you have... yeah, a great rest of your day. I will be back Wednesday, 7 a.m. Pacific time, doing another co-working stream. We'll be doing, I've said it like 3 times now, but we'll be doing Pixelite, drawing more icons and emotes, because I'm having way too much fun drawing them. They're a lot of fun. That's what we're doing on Wednesday. And yeah, I guess that's all I have to say. Yeah, I hope you all have a great day. Until I see you again. Until next time. Bye-bye.